Hi children, in this video I am going to explain to you the electric potential due to a dipole. Electric potential due to a dipole. Field already we have calculated in the previous chapter. We are going to do the derivation for electric potential due to a dipole. Whenever we talk of dipole, we have to remember that there will be three cases. What is that? What are they? One is along the axial line, another is along equatorial line. The third one, I have given the derivation. I did not give the derivation in the videos, but derivation can be done. It takes some time. That's why I did not do the derivation. But this derivation we have to do because it is given in the textbook. So textbook derivations are to be followed as it is. If something is not given in the textbook, means that is beyond your board level. Those things will be discussed in competitive. I will be uploading competitive videos also in due course of time. Now, electric potential due to a dipole. First, we go for at a point on its axial line. At a point on its axial line. This was asked a number of times. See this. This is a dipole, minus Q1 plus Q. The separation between them is 2A. Okay. This is center of the dipole. Got it? We know that the dipole moment is defined as Q into 2A. Right? These things are known to us. This is the axial line. Here at point P, they are asking us to find the potential. This point is at a distance r from the center of the dipole. So that point will be at what distance from plus Q? R minus A. From minus Q, it will be at r plus A. Potential is a scalar. So potential along the axial line at a point P. Potential along the axial line at a point P is equal to potential due to positive charge plus potential due to negative charge. No vector notation because potential is a scalar. While calculating potential due to positive charge, once again I give the expression for potential due to a point charge. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by distance. This is the expression for potential due to a point charge. Same. Positive charge. What is the distance of positive charge? R minus A. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R minus A plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This is the potential due to negative charge minus Q by R minus R plus A. Minus Q by R plus A. So this is minus Q is at what distance from P? R plus A. So 1 upon Q by 4 pi epsilon naught is taken common here. So we have 1 by R plus A minus 1 by R minus A minus 1 by R plus A. We have to simplify this expression. Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R plus A minus of R minus A divided by LCM is R square minus A square. You will get Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into R plus A minus R plus A by R square minus A square. R get cancelled. So in the numerator we have Q by 4 pi epsilon naught times. In the numerator I have 2A. Denominator I have R square minus A square. What is Q into 2A? As I told you, Q into 2A is the dipole moment. So the expression for electric potential at a point on the axial line is given by P by Q into 2A is replaced by dipole moment P vec P. P by 4 pi epsilon naught R square minus A square. Right? This is the expression. Suppose for a short dipole. Short dipole means these cases we have discussed earlier also. Short dipole means the length of the dipole is very small when compared with this axial distance is smaller. In case of short dipole, A square is very much negligible when compared with R square. So, wherever you get R square minus A square, you can directly write R square here. So, due to an electric dipole at an axial point, the potential is given by P by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. So, potential is inversely proportional to R square, but field is inversely proportional to R cube in case of short dipole. If you remember, field is inversely proportional to R cube, potential is inversely proportional to R square due to a dipole. If it is due to a point charge, potential is inversely proportional to R. If it is a point charge, electric field is inversely proportional to R square. See, a question can be framed on these four concepts. Very important. Potential due to a dipole is inversely proportional to R square. Electric field due to a dipole is inversely proportional to R cube. Potential due to point charge is inversely proportional to R. Field due to point charge is inversely proportional to R square. There was a question, what is the contrast between the potential due to a point charge and the dipole? The contrasting point is, potential due to a dipole is inversely proportional to square of the distance. Potential due to a point charge is inversely proportional to the distance. At a point on the axial line, we have obtained the expression is P by 4 pi epsilon naught R square if you consider the dipole to be very small. If not, then you have to go for this expression. Okay. Next. Now we go for potential at a point on its equatorial line. So, electric potential due to a dipole on its equatorial line. Right? I take a dipole here, minus Q1 plus Q. The separation is 2A. So, dipole moment is defined as Q into 2A. Over. This is the center of the dipole. This is the equatorial line. The distance is R. The distance of the point from the center of the dipole is R. If this is 2A, this will be A and this will be A. Minus Q charge is at a distance same as that of plus Q charge from the same point. That means if this is X, this is also X. What is the value of this X? This is a right angle triangle. X equal to root of R square plus A square. So, this is a point on the equatorial line. Very simple. Potential at a point on the equatorial line is equal to potential due to positive charge plus potential due to negative charge. Potential due to positive charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by X. Due to negative charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q by X. So, if you see, notice these two, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by X minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by X, both get cancelled, it is 0. So, at any point on the equatorial line of an electric dipole is 0. According to the definition of potential, potential is equal to work done by charge. So, work done is equal to charge into potential or potential difference. Since at any point on the equatorial line of the dipole, the potential is zero. This is always zero. Q q naught into 0, so work done is 0. Very, very important point. That means you take a dipole, minus charge plus charge, this is the equatorial line of the dipole. On the equatorial line, you want to move a charge from one point to another point, wherever you want to move, anywhere, from any point to any point. What is the potential at this point? 0. What is the potential at this point? 0. When the potential is 0 at these two points, what is the potential difference? 0. Then what is the work done in moving charge from A to B? 0. So, work done in moving any charge from one point to another, along its equatorial line, along the equatorial line of a dipole is 0. So simple. So on the equatorial line, the work done is 0. This derivation will not be asked in the exam, but they will give a numerical to test whether we know this concept or not. But axial line derivation they will give. Now we go for any arbitrary point. Suppose electric potential at a general point due to a dipole. General point in the sense, as we have explained to you in the previous case, same. There is a charge minus Q, there is a charge plus Q. Okay. And this is 2A. So as you know that dipole moment equal to Q into 2A. This is center of the dipole. Right. Here at a point they are asking the potential. What we have to do, the distance of this point is R. I take it as vector notation R bar. Okay. Since dipole moment is P bar, minus charge to positive charge, dipole moment is P bar in this direction. Here I take a point. Let it be some R. Point is R. This point is A and this point is B. Now I join these two. This is R1 bar. This is R2 bar. This is R2 and this is R1. Simply you can keep R1, R2 also, no problem. Right? Now, this distance, I drop a perpendicular. Let this angle be theta, so that the coordinates of R is R comma theta, known as polar coordinates. So this I take it as N. This is R1 minus R2. Clear, right? This distance is R1, this distance is R2, then this distance will be the subtraction, right? Difference of these two. Because yaha se yaha tak, from here to here, the distances are same. This is the excess. What is that? R1 minus R2. One more thing, we need to go for an approximation in this. If this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. Because dipole is very small, lengthwise it is very small, the point is very far. That means the variation in the value of theta is negligible. So if this is theta, this is also theta. I hope you understood this. These considerations are very important. Next, this distance is R. This is less than R, this is greater than R. I hope you understood. R is greater than R2. R is less than R1. In the derivation, wherever we come across R1 into R2, we can take it as R square approximation. This is approximation. So by considering this concept theta, by considering the product R1, R2 approximate to R square, Another important point is here we have a rectangle triangle. What is AN? AN can be taken as 2A cos theta. AB cos theta means 2A cos theta. I hope you understood this. See, there is a small right angle triangle formed. This is right angle. This is theta. This is 2A. Then this will be 2A cos theta. Got it? This is A, this is B, and this is N. Now we go for the derivation. So keeping in mind all these, this approximation and this approximation and this fact, let us go for the derivation. Potential at a point R, I directly write R comma theta, is equal to potential due to positive charge plus potential due to negative charge. Here and here the charges are having same magnitude, and in the expression 4 pi epsilon naught will be common. So directly I take Q by 4 pi epsilon naught common. If it is due to positive charge, distance R2 will come. If it is due to negative charge, the charge is minus. Moreover, the distance is R1, that R1 will come. So I take it as Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R1 minus R2 divided by R1 R2. What is R1 minus R2? See this diagram AN. What is AN? AN is R1 minus R2 only. But AN, according to us, it is 2A cos theta. So I write P by 4 pi epsilon naught 2A cos theta divided by R1 R2. According to our approximation, the product R1 R2 is R square. And this fact reveals that Q into 2A is dipole moment. So I take it as P cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. This is the potential at any general point of an electric dipole. Got it? From this, for axial line ke pass, along its axial line, you know that theta is 0. See, axial line means point will be here along this line. So theta will be 0. If theta is 0, cos 0 is 1, so along the axial line for short dipole, potential is P by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. For points on the equatorial lines line means this theta would become 90 now. This theta becomes 90. Cos theta is 0 in this expression. So along the equatorial line, the potential is 0. I hope you understood, children. So with this, we have finished the derivation of electric potential due to a dipole at an axial line, at a point on the axial line, comma equatorial line, and at a general point also. First and last derivations are important. Second derivation is important for numericals and as well as one mark MCQs also, right?